Hello, hi friends, my name is Nilesh. In this video, we are going to see how to use an interesting feature of Docker Compose, which is called as include. It's been around for a while and I discovered it recently. Let's get started and see how to use this include feature. Here on the screen, you can see that I've got a legacy Docker Compose file, or the file that I've been using for quite a while. If you have been following my YouTube videos, you know that I've been using this example of Tech Talks producer and consumer as part of the Cloud Native Ninja series. And I had demonstrated how to use Docker Compose to build and run multi-container apps. In this video, we will see how to enhance it further. Now, if you look at this file, there are two services which are used to build and which are used to start using the Docker Compose file. We have the definition for Tech Talks producer and Tech Talks consumer. Before I go into the include, let me switch over to the terminal and see if we have any Docker images currently. I don't have any Docker image running on my machine, or I don't have any Docker image locally available on my machine. That's a good starting point, which gives us a good indicator or a clean slate to start with. So how do we get started with include? Include allows us to include the contents of another Docker Compose file as a dependency or as a reference in our current Docker Compose file. So I will use this and separate these two services into two different files. Let's start with separating the consumer. Assume that the producer and consumer, these two microservices, are developed by two separate teams, and we have a dependency on both of these services working together for running this application end to end. So I have this Docker Compose file, which contains just the definition for Tech Talks consumer, which is a pretty standard Compose file with the list of services and then what is the build context and what is the image that needs to be generated or that needs to be used when we run the Docker Compose up command. Pretty standard things here. The things get interesting on the include side, or where we want to include this Docker Compose as a reference. So let's go to the Tech Talks consumer or Docker Compose consumer, and there is this file called as include. docker-compose.net acr include, where we include this as a directive, or we use the include directive to reference the docker-compose.net consumer compose file, which is the name of that file, and then we define the services which are part of the producer. So what we are saying here is we want to include the contents of the consumer into this Docker Compose file, which contains the producer definition or Tech Talks producer service related definition. What this allows us to do is to separate different services into different Docker Compose file and include them as references. You might have seen in some of the earlier videos or in some other videos where we can have two or three Docker Compose file, and then when we run the Docker Compose command, we give the list of these files. That is alternate approach of doing something similar, but I prefer this because this allows us to have one common place. When we use those multiple files, we still have to make those changes in multiple places, whereas using the include approach, it allows us to centralize the changes to one place, and wherever this included as a reference, this particular file is included as a reference, all those references would get updated. We don't have to make the same changes multiple times. So that is the benefit of using this. So let's go and make a quick run of this command. So I've created a markdown file with the list of all the commands that we need. We looked at the Docker Compose or Docker images file. Let's go and run this command, which is for building the image. Now in this case, I'm using Docker Compose standard command. I'm giving the file reference as docker-compose.net acr include, which is the file which is having the include reference or include directive. And I want to build an image, and I'm giving Tech Talks producer as the service name. This is because I'm using another construct here, which is called as the image cache or build cache. I've done a video on this earlier. This allows us to run the builds faster, or it allows us to cache the dependencies which are required for Docker build. So while this is building, I will also keep the other command handy, which we will use for building both the producer and consumer. The reason I'm building just the Tech Talks producer here is, since I don't have any images, I don't have that image cache build, and I want to build that dependencies, or I want to populate the cache with the dependencies which are required for building my producer and consumer. This will take few seconds, and once the image cache is built, once all the dependencies from the NuGet packages has been downloaded, it will build the container image for me. And then we will run the Docker compose again, the build command, but this time we will run it without the Tech Talks producer as the service name, because we want to build both the producer and the consumer. This is the legacy syntax of using docker-compose. Let me go and change it in the file itself here. In the new version of Docker, the Docker compose is a top level command. So we can use Docker compose, and that is what I want to use here going forward. So here we can see that it is now completed the build, and it has created this image called as Tech Talks producer. Now I want to build the producer and consumer together, and I'm running the Docker compose command with just the build flag without specifying the service name. And you can see here that the consumer has been built instantaneously, because we have that cached dependencies, and the dependencies are almost similar between the producer and the consumer. So there we have both the producer and consumer created. And if I run the Docker images command now, here we can see that they have been built 25 and 35 seconds ago. Now let's go and run one more command, which is to bring up all these services together using Docker compose up. And here we can see that both the producer and consumer have been started instantaneously again. And if I run Docker container and ls, I should see both the containers running, which have been created 15 seconds ago. And as a housekeeping, let's bring everything down. So if I run the Docker compose down command here with the same file name, which is our Docker compose.net acr include.yml file, it brings down all the services. So here we can see that using the include directive, we are able to include additional files, and this makes maintaining our Docker compose files very easy. Imagine that you have infrastructure services running like Kibana, Grafana, or Prometheus, which are required for multiple applications. Instead of having them embedded in each of those particular Docker compose files for the applications, now we can separate them into its dedicated compose file, and that can be included in any number of applications. It helps in improving the maintainability of the compose or the Docker files as such. I hope you found this useful. In case you found this content useful, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and spread it with your friends. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence. Thanks for watching.